Okay, is it clear now? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Now better.
Okay. I ask you first question. Zubair will tell me, okay? First of all. Okay, Zubair?
Yes, sir.
In which holy month Pakistan made?
Pakistan made in holy month of Ramzan, sir.
That's good. Okay, I ask you then, you have to reply me, what happened in 1948?
Qaid Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah was dead.
Was died.
Died.
Yes, sir. Was died on 11 September in 1948. Okay. 1948. I ask the next question, Zishan. Other tragedy also took place in 1948. What was that tragedy?
Sir, the tragedy is Kashmir, sir.
Yes, what happened?
Kashmir will separate, sir.
Yes, yes. Pakistan lost Kashmir. Of course.
Yes, sir.
Okay, I ask you next question. Tariq. How are you, Tariq?
Yes, sir.
You're right? Fine, nice?
Yes. I'm fine, good, sir.
Okay, that's good. I ask you a question. What happened, Tariq? You have to tell me what happened in 1951.
1951?
Yeah.
Sorry.
Yes.
Sir, I have.
Okay. Zubair, can you tell? Zain, can you tell?
Slap from mind.
Khan Lakhdari Khan was killed at Lakhdari Bagh in Rawalpindi. First Prime Minister of Pakistan, Khan Lakhdari Khan was killed at Lakhdari Bagh in Rawalpindi, okay? Zishan?
Yes, sir.
What happened in
1965? 1965, sir, India attacked us and we won, sir.
Yes. India attacked on Pakistan and Pakistan won the war with India in 1965. Pakistan forces defeated to Indian forces. Pakistan was winner in the war of 1965. Zubair, you tell me.
Yes, sir.
What happened in 1971?
Sir, in 1971, Bangladesh was separate.
No. Bangladesh made after separation.
Separation, yes, sir. Separate with Pakistan.
Pakistan lost East Pakistan in 1971.
Lost East Pakistan. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Indeed, sir.
Okay. Now, Tariq, what is the national language of Pakistan?
National language in Urdu, Pakistan.
Yeah, why not? Urdu
national language in Urdu.
Certainly, of course. Okay. What is the national dress of Pakistan then?
Shalwar kameez, sir.
Shalwar suit, yes. Suit is the national dress of Pakistan. Okay. Now, Tariq, you tell me that what happened in 1992?
In 1992, Pakistan won the World Cup.
In which game?
cricket, won the World Cup in cricket.
Certainly. Who was the captain?
Imran Khan.
Who is Imran Khan?
Prime Minister of Pakistan.
Yes. He is the Prime Minister of Pakistan nowadays.
Yes, sir.
Okay, of course. He also made captain in politics. Like he was captain in Pakistan cricket team. Same here. He made Prime Minister of Pakistan. So also he's captain here in politics. Okay.
Yes. Yes.
Sir, okay. Sajjad Sheth, he is not connected with the class.
Who?
Not joining the class. Sajjad sir, he's trying to join
my
us.
God. So he, I think his cell phone is new. I think so. There's a problem with him.
Yes, sir.
You can guide.
He text me personally. I guide him, sir. मैंने link भी भेजा सर उसे.
Did you guide him? Zen.
Sir, I'll send him another link of our.
Okay, that's good. That maybe he can contact in few moments. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I ask Zubair. I ask you a question. What happened in 1857, Zubair?
1857, sir. The British rulers captured subcontinent, sir. And Muslims community.
Fadlur Rahman, please quiet your.
No.
Mic.
Yes, Fadlur Rahman came. Yeah, how are you, Fadlur Rahman?
I am fine.
Okay. Okay. So I repeat my question. Who will reply me? Zishan will reply me. Same question I asked from Zubair. What happened in 1857?
Sir, 1857, the British rulers came and they machinations on Muslims and Hindus, and they are rulers in 1857.
Yes, British rulers captured the subcontinent in 1857. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I ask you next question from Zen. Zen, you have to tell me that what happened in 2005?
Sir, zilzala was came.
Sorry?
And many, sir, zilzala.
Earthquake.
Many people were died. Earthquake, sir. Many people were died in our.
There, mostly people were died.
Died. Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay. So, Zishan.
Yes, sir.
When Pakistan started dummy program?
Sorry, sir.
When Pakistan started atomic program? In which year Pakistan started atomic program?
Sir, I don't remember that day.
Yes, anyone can apply? Nobody knows?
Sir, I think 1978, sir.
1974. In 1974, Pakistan started atomic program.
1974, yes, sir.
Okay. Who will tell me who was Arif Karim, who was she? Fadlur Rahman?
Arif Karim.
Fadlur Rahman. Can you tell me who was Arif Karim, who was she? Fadlur Rahman is quite. Okay. Anyone can reply me? Who was Arfa Kareem?
Arfa Kareem, sir.
Randhawa is founder of IT.
Yeah.
Software, sir.
Software.
Yes, sir.
She made software.
She made software, yes, sir.
And she made world record.
World record, yes, sir.
And her name is mentioned in the Guinness Book of Record. Her name is mentioned there.
Record, yes.
As a Pakistani sir. Girl. Okay?
As a Pakistani first girl, sir.
Yeah. Okay, so I ask you next question. What were the major differences among Muslims and Hindus in the subcontinent? Zubair?
Major issues, sir. Sir, Hindus. Hindus don't want to Muslims government or rule, sir. And he support to British rulers and make machinations for Muslims. So Muslim war lost their government.
No. I'm not asking about it now. My question is, what were the major differences among Muslims and Hindus in the subcontinent? Why it was impossible to stay together in the subcontinent as Congress struggled for United India? Nothing was matching among
Muslims. Yes, sir.
Nothing was common. Nothing was common in two nations. Okay.
Yes,
the religious is the main major.
Yes. It's a major and main problem.
Yes, the religious.
Certainly, Muslims and Hindus, can't stay together in the subcontinent because everything was quite different from each other among Muslims and Hindus. Nothing was common between Hindu and Muslim nations.
Yes, sir.
I ask you next question. I ask you, why Muslims hated from English language in the subcontinent?
Sir, because Muslims hate the British people. So but that's why.
No, because Muslims hated from British rulers. It was the reason behind?
Behind this, sir.
Yes. And the language of British rulers was English. It was the reason behind. So Muslims also hated from English language.
Yes, sir.
Who was, what did Sir Syed Ahmed Khan for Muslims in the subcontinent? Anyone can reply me?
Sir, Sayyid Ahmad Khan observed the situation. He wrote many books for Muslim and told to Muslim that if you need progress, if you want development, then you have to learn English language by all means.
Certainly. Quite right. He told to Muslims that you can't get progress since when you don't learn English language. Yes, he realized to Muslims that you have to learn English language by all means. For this purpose, he opened Aligarh College and Aligarh University. And a large number of Muslims learned English language from there and got higher education from there. Okay.
Yes, sir.
What happened in 1940?
1940, sir, the Pakistan. In 23rd March 1914, passed a resolution of Pakistan.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. That's it, sir.
Yes, why not? You're right.
Minare Pakistan.
Yes, at Minare Pakistan. For specific place, Pakistan. We have to use at.
Yes.
For historical place, we have to use at.
At, yes, sir.
At is preposition. Okay. You have to tell me that what is the major and main problem in Pakistan?
Sir, the major and main problem is many problem is here, sir, in is here, but his problem is illiteracy.
Certainly.
Health and
corruption.
Crime, robbery, etc. Sir.
Yes, Pakistan has many problems, but I ask you, what is the main and basic problem in Pakistan? The main problem in Pakistan is illiteracy.
Illiteracy, yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Pakistan, sir, Pakistan is poor country. Pakistan is underdevelopment country. Pakistan has many problems. First of all, main and basic problem, illiteracy.
Illiteracy is major and main problem. Pakistan has many problems because Pakistan, you are right, Pakistan is an underdeveloped country. Pakistan has many problems. Pakistan is a poor country.
We have few schools, we have few colleges, we have few universities,
certainly,
academy.
Certainly.
Education facility are not available in the village.
Yes, yes, yes. Good. Tariq, it means you did much practice. Good. Pakistan has what? Tell me, think about what is water problem in Pakistan?
Problem, load shedding, and that is the most problem, unemployment.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Good. What is water problem in Pakistan? Can you throw light on this issue? What is water problem in Pakistan?
In our Sindh area, sir, there is many main issue about water.
Yes. Yes.
Especially in Thar, sir. Thar, province of Sindh.
Desert areas.
Yeah, yeah. We have few dams in Pakistan. Most people drink dirty water. Population is too much in Pakistan. Yes. We have not many dams. Most people can't drink neat and clean water. Most people drink dirty water. Especially in village.
We have health.
Yes, what is health problem? What is health problem in Pakistan?
Main about sir garbage.
Hmm.
Our people throw garbage.
Okay.
Anywhere.
Right.
That's why our people. Our people were
we have few hospitals in Pakistan. In village we have not medical facilities. We are victim of shortage of doctors. We have few hospitals. Mostly people die without treatment. Mostly patients die without treatment because population is too much and the medical facilities can't fulfill the needs of health of population in Pakistan. Okay, what is unemployment? How you can explain to unemployment problem in Pakistan? Anyone?
Recommended people.
Sorry, sir. What do you say, sir?
Yes, Zubair.
What do you say, sir?
Recommended people.
I can't understand.
Most people are unemployed in Pakistan. Unemployment problem is major, also major problem in Pakistan. Why? How you can throw light on what is the reason behind why unemployment is going on peak in Pakistan?
Sir, because Pakistan has a few sources and Pakistan have a large population.
Okay. Yes, main reason is most people are illiterate. We have few opportunities of jobs. Most people are unconscious about different skills.
Yes,
most people have not experience. Corruption is very common. Recommendation is very common. Bribe is very common in Pakistan. So most people are unemployed in Pakistan. Got it now? On the other hand,
yes, sir.
Pakistan is victim of overpopulation. There is too much population in Pakistan. So unemployment increased rapidly in Pakistan. Okay, these are the reasons. I ask you next question from Tariq. Tariq, you have to tell me.
Yes, sir.
What is corruption? What is corruption? How you can define it?
Yes, sir. Corruption is. Corruption.
Fazlurman also can. Fazlurman can. No problem. Otherwise, if you have problem.
I describe this issue.
Yeah. Why not?
Yes. Corruption is also a major issue in Pakistan.
Why not? Why not? Why not?
Because in every department, corruption.
Certain.
And corrupt. Corrupt person are they are doing and they what I say,
corrupt people are too much in different departments.
Yes, in every department, corrupt people are. Yes.
Why not? Why not? You know that corruption means that people have to work and people have to people have to get bribed. Okay, it is corruption and it is unfair corruption. People have to, people get the bribe and earn the money by unfair means. It's corruption. Got it now? Recommendation. Recommend people, are engaged or busy in recommendation and bribe. It is in whole country. So it is corruption. So corruption is increased too much in Pakistan.
Yes.
Even in our departments, even in education, there is too much corruption. In health department, there is too much corruption. In all departments of Pakistan, corruption is going on peak. In government departments, and private sector.
Sir, corruption is not doing good for us.
In his own sector.
Yeah. Why not?
I'm saying that every person is a corrupt because every person doing corruption in his own circle.
Yes. Okay. So can you tell me about achievements of Pakistan? Anyone can reply me? Who will throw light on achievements of Pakistan? Tariq or Zubair or Zain? Anyone can reply me?
Yes, sir. First of all, Pakistan is made, God gifted Pakistan.
Yeah.
Is made in holy month of Ramadan.
Certainly.
And 1965, Pakistan won the war with India.
Yeah.
The state of Pakistan had very less sources.
Certainly. Pakistan won the Cricket World Cup.
Yes, sir. Pakistan won the World Cup in 1992.
Yeah. Pakistan made world champion in hockey,
and also Pakistan won the match of hockey, and hockey is our national game. So in 1984, sir.
Yeah, yeah.
Why not? That is a
and great Pakistan experience. Made power, sir. Atomic power.
On 28th May 1998.
On
28th,
yes, sir.
Yeah. Alpha made world record in the field of IT. She made software.
Yes, sir.
Her name was mentioned in the Guinness Book of Record as a Pakistani girl. Just her age was 16 years at that time.
Yes, sir.
These are all achievements.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pakistan started atomic program in 1974. Okay. Can you tell me about tragedies in Pakistan? Tragedies in Pakistan. Who will tell me? Yes, Fazlur Rehman, you tell us about tragedies in Pakistan.
What?
Tragedies. Tragedies.
Tragedies.
Tragedies. Tragedies. Tragedy. Tragedies.
Okay.
Sad events.
Red.
Tragedies.
About?
Sad events took place in Pakistan. Sad events.
Events.
Sad events.
Okay.
In 1948, Qaed Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah was died.
What died?
And in 2005,
sir, earthquake. First tragedy of Pakistan. When Pakistan was independent, the first tragedy is Kashmir, sir.
Pakistan lost Kashmir, sir, in 1948.
Tragedy, yes, the East Pakistan in 1971.
Yeah.
Separated Pakistan. This is a big and major tragedy for Pakistan. In our national history.
Yeah. Second tragedy.
Yeah, yeah.
And third tragedy is Sir Kargil.
Yes.
Kargil?
Yes, sir.
In Kargil war, Pakistan was winner. It is achievement. Not tragedy. I didn't mention about this war. Certainly Pakistan was achiever.
Sir, but we lost many.
Not me.
Many, sir, soldiers.
You can hold your...
In Liaquat Bagh,
I don't know it now.
Liaquat Ali Khan was...
Yes. It is political.
Killed.
I tell you, but it was a political issue.
There was.
You know...
Strategy. Okay, sir.
In Kargil war, Pakistan was winner. But suddenly, war stopped. So, by government of Pakistan, stopped the war. And Pakistan, you know, Chief Army Staff said, no, he said that we are just near the victory, so I don't want to stop this war. I don't deny that in every war, our Pakistani soldiers offered many sacrifices for dear homeland. I don't ignore their sacrifices for Pakistan. Okay?
But sir, India occupied on Kargil, sir, is...
Nowadays, sir, we lost Kashmir.
Yes, yes, why not?
Kashmir.
We lost Kashmir.
This government.
Certainly. I tell you one thing. I tell you one thing. Problem is here.
Yes, sir.
If, you know, I tell you one thing that if, you know, the Pakistani government said that stop the war. If, you know, war did not stop, most probably Pakistan was winner, most probably. We made loser instead of we can make winner at that time. In other words, it was tragedy, okay? We made loser in the Kargil war. Otherwise, we were winner if we don't stop the war, okay?
Okay, sir.
All right, sir.
Okay. So I did not tell you about this war. Actually, there was complexity. Okay, I did not mention it in my lecture yesterday. Anyways, now I need your suggestions how we can develop to Pakistan. Zishan can throw light on this, okay, on this issue. How we can develop to Pakistan? I need your suggestions from Zishan Ahmed. Zishan, otherwise Tariq will tell us. Nobody knows how we can develop to Pakistan, how we can progress to, how we can develop to Pakistan, how we can progress to Pakistan.
Is the man. Sir, first of all, who stopped the corruption?
Yeah.
And
we
increase literacy rate, sir.
We increased education?
Yes. Yes, sir. Literacy rate or education, sir.
Yes.
Yes.
Government should take serious step in education sector. Many schools,
yes,
colleges, and universities should open in whole country. Many academies and institutes should,
yes,
open in the country.
And also, government should take the steps in the health sector.
Right, right. Quite right. Quite right.
And also, stop the crime, robbery.
Certainly.
This sector also needs improvement.
Yeah, why not? Merit should be imposed. Merit is obligatory in the country. Justice
yes,
is obligatory.
Yes, a fair judiciary system is also needed to our in our country.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Right. Right. And mostly people should learn English language. Then we can decrease unemployment in the country. Mostly people are jobless. Why most people are jobless in Pakistan? Because most people are unconscious about English language. You can find what I said now. Most people are unemployed in Pakistan. Most people can't get job because most people are unconscious about English language. It is the main reason behind now. So most people should learn English language.